love her energy, and her name is Laura Love for a reason, because she exudes love, and she exudes patience and peace, and she walks this journey, and she's been doing it a long time with her kids. And so I wanted her to come and share with you. Laura currently teaches classes in Orange County. She leads wellness programs and yoga retreats. Her goal is to share what she has learned so far on her journey with her students, learn from her students, and move forward with them every day. It's changed her life profoundly in a way that she sees the world in connection to everything and everyone around her. She feels her purpose in this life is to share that light with others. I'm so honored. She's got a long list of credentials behind her, but I'm just honored to share her light with you, because really that's what matters, because she's totally qualified in every way. But I want her to share her light with you and nourish you in a deep way today. And so please give a warm Moms in Charge welcome to the beautiful Laura Love. Thank you, Laura.
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you so much for having me here. I feel so honored to be part of this, part here at the Montage, and just part of this movement in general. It's so amazing. I'm a mama myself. I have two kids, and they're big now. They're teenagers. I've got high schoolers. So all of watching all of this, I was like, where was this? You know, where was this 10 years ago when I kind of made that big shift with my family into holistic healing and natural foods and all of that about 10 years ago. And it's not easy, you know, and it's not easy to be that mom that brings a kale salad to the party, you know? But consciousness is growing, all of this is growing, and it's so beautiful. So I'm really proud, I mean, to be part of it, and good for all of you for coming together and facilitating community and growth and consciousness. And so there are so many ways to kind of grow and evolve, and I think that what you're doing here is huge. You know, what we eat, what we intake is huge in our vibration that we're putting out there, and what we're cultivating in as well. So, you know, people like Jenny Ross and everything that's going on here is just amazing. And then Daddy also mentioned that has, you know, there's also the spiritual aspect of it, your journey and your path, and we're all different places, and we're all exactly where we should be. And what I do is just, I'm just a yoga teacher, you know, I'm here to facilitate movement, to help you to find your breath, and through that, you know, it's a simple practice. You know, there's nothing magical that's going on your yoga mat, but for me, finding my yoga practice truthfully changed my world. And so, for a lot of you, I'm sure you've done yoga before, and this would be just like a nice little mellow taste of yoga practice. Maybe for some of you, this is your first class. I don't know. So hopefully to inspire that kind of growth. And I hope that you enjoy, and I'll also show you a breathing technique as we go through towards the end, because realizing that we're all moms, there are certain things that we can do to quickly cultivate our own inner peace. So this whole idea of nourishing mom today, where I come through and the yoga practice comes through, is before you can spread your light to your children and your family and your workplace and everyone that you come into contact to, is really you have to first take care of you, right? Like, this has got to be, you've got to get yourself set up to where you're in a place where you are now just, you know, exuding out. So we're going to focus on cultivating our inner peace today, so that when you go home and through the next week or so, you can kind of come back to that and you know, just take a breath and realize that you have a choice. You don't have a choice of what's coming at you, right? You don't have a choice if your kid's throwing his almond milk at you, but you have a choice on how you respond, and through that, beautiful things happen. So we're going to start in the seat today. Cross your legs, sit up nice and tall, and the lovely Ann is going to give us a little bit of music today. This will be a taste of yoga. It's not a full class. It'll be about 25 minutes or so. Take what feels good, leave out what doesn't. All right? We're going to start with our hands at our heart center in prayer. Close your eyes. Your shoulders rest back and down. Sit up nice and tall. Crown of your head up towards the clouds. shoulders back, elbows close. And let's just start to cultivate that breath. Inhale through your nose. Slow deep breath in. Exhale through your nose. Let it go. Shoulders relax a little bit. Taking a slow six count inhale. Take your time and really drag the breath in. Focusing on the exhale as well, aiming it to make it as equal in length as the inhale. Asana pranayama, equal breathing. Breathe in slow, breathe out slow. So by focusing in on our breath, we're starting to just really cultivate that sense of calm, that sense of peace. Just breathe it in right now. Slow, gentle inhales. Slow, gentle exhales. Setting an intention for our practice this morning, I came across this quote by Elizabeth Gilbert, the author of Eat, Pray, Love, that I wanted to share with you. She said, "We don't realize that somewhere within us all, there does exist a supreme self who is eternally at peace." To find that little bit of peace, that little bit of sweetness, and to remind yourself that no matter what goes on in your world, it's always there. You can always come back to it. Take one more long inhale, sitting up tall, and a slow exhale, letting it go. Gently on your next inhale, open up your eyes, lift your arms up to the sky. Lift up, reach up and lengthen, reach up towards the clouds. Then we're going to reach to the right. So bring your right hand down and your left arm up and over. You can bring your forearm to the earth or just your hand. But roll your shoulder back and shine your heart out and breathe. Feel it all the way down your side body. Get a little longer, invite it in. Create some space right here. Breathe, expand, open, hold. Good, inhale, rise. Let's come on over to the other side. Long side body stretch. Roll your shoulder back, shine your heart out. Breathe in through your nose. Breathe out through your nose. Hips are rooted, side body is lengthening. Reach a little further, hold in that space. Good, inhale, we rise up slow. Lift your arms all the way up to the top. As you exhale, bring your arms behind you. Interlace your grip. Inhale, open up your chest and squeeze your palms. Exhale, shift the weight forward. So maybe you come down halfway, maybe three quarters, or maybe your head can touch the ground. It doesn't really matter. As long as you can feel this in your chest, feel your chest open up, squeeze your palms flat. Take two breaths right here in this position. Rise up slow and easy. As you exhale, bring your hands out in front of you. Come onto tabletop. Make your way onto all fours, hands and knees. Hands, wrists under shoulders, knees under hips. We'll move through cat-cow a few times to warm up the spine. Inhale, let your belly hang down. Lift your heart forward, gaze up. Exhale, round. Pull your navel to your spine, tuck your chin tight. Inhale, belly down, heart forward, roll the shoulders back, look up. Exhale, round, tuck your chin, pull in tight. Inhale, belly down, heart forward, roll the shoulders back, look up. Exhale, round, pull in, tuck your chin in tight. Inhale to a neutral spine. There for your exhale. Slowly tuck your toes under. Push your hips all the way up to the sky, downward facing dog. Start to walk this first one out a little bit. Bend your knees back and forth a few times. Just bring in a little bit of movement to the back side of the body. Start to warm up. Good. And now press your heels down towards the earth. Make sure that your toes are in line with your heels. Nothing should be bowing out and nothing's bowing in. Feet are about hip distance or maybe a little wider if you need it. Slide your upside down V. Breathe in slow and breathe out slow. So the most important part of your yoga practice is your attention to your breath. So let's really cultivate that awareness now. So slow, drawn out, inhale, take your time, lungs expanding. And your exhale is just as slow, and you're able to push yourself a little bit deeper as you get into this position. So every inhale offers space, every exhale offers depth or progress. Just find a little bit of space here. Feel your body start to open. You've got about three more deep breaths. So just find your best expression of your downward facing dog. Long drawn out inhales and slow exhales. On your next inhale, shift into your high plank pose. So it's an easy transition from your down dog. You're just going to shift right forward. Holding here. Good. We've got a couple slow breaths here. We want to keep our bottom down. Keep the core active. Now, if there are any mamas to be in this group today, okay, mama to be, I see you right there. You're just going to drop to your knees, okay? The rest of us, take one more long inhale here. As you exhale, come all the way down to your belly. Chin is out, tops of feet on the earth. Inhale, lift up, low cobra. Push your shoulders back and away from you. Keep your elbows close. Press the tops of the feet onto the ground. Lift your knees up off of the ground. Hold. You're using just the strength of your low back to do this. And then exhale, lower down, slow and easy. Tuck your toes. Inhale, high plank pose. Exhale, push your hips all the way back up. Downward facing dog. Good. Three deep breaths right here in your down dog. Find a little bit of space. Slide your shoulders all the way down your back. Inhaling slow. Exhaling slow. Push a little bit deeper. Can you find a little more space? And then gaze forward to the top of your mat. Slowly walk on up to the top of your mat. Open up your feet about hip distance. Grab opposite elbows. Slight bend to your knees. Let your head hang heavy and start to rock it out. Ragdoll pose. Just start to sway from side to side. Let your head hang all the way down and let your neck relax. Think about your head like this really heavy bowling ball. Just let it hang down and let your neck get a little longer. You're creating space between the vertebrae. You're lengthening out. You're decompressing your spine and you're releasing tension and stress. Take one more long inhale in this pose. As you exhale, drop your hands down to the earth. Bring the right hand in the center, palm or fingertips touching the ground. Inhale, lift your left arm high, and let's bend that right knee. Have a nice deep bend to your right knee and try to keep your left leg straight. Gaze is up, you're rolling your shoulder back, and you're shining your heart up toward the sky. Feeling this in your hips, releasing tension, warming through the spine. Inhaling slow, exhaling slow, hold it right there. And then release, bring that left hand down. Inhale, lift the right arm high. And you're gonna bend your left knee and feel this nice deep stretch to the back side of the body and the hips. We're rolling the shoulder back. We're shining the heart up. Our breath is slow and we're patient. Breathe in through your nose, breathe out through your nose. Hold right there, you've got one more breath. Reach back one more inch. Good, exhale, bring your hand down slow. Toe heel your feet all the way back together. Toes and heels touch. Inhale to a flat back, fingertips at your shin. Slight tuck to your chin. You could bounce a cup of hot tea on your back. Exhale, fold forward and let it go. Again, inhale to a flat back, halfway lift, fingertips at the shins, crown shines forward. Exhale, let that go. Head hangs down. Inhale, flat back, halfway lift, hold it, squeeze your shoulder blades together. Exhale, fold a little deeper, let it go. And now bend your knees. Sit down in your chair pose. On an inhale, lift your arms up, pull your core in tight. So the knees are together, your feet are together. Your abdominals are engaged and your arms are reaching. Your pinkies shine forward. hold your breath. Breathe in slow. Breathe out slow. Sit a little lower. That core is active. You are strong. You are stable. Can you sit a little lower? Breathe in slow. Breathe out slow. One more breath. Sit down one more inch. Hold it there. Open up your eyes. Straighten out your legs and bring your hands to your heart. Samnasitihi. Take a slow breath in and a slow breath out. Maybe come back to that intention, right? Cultivating that internal peace. Take a long, drawn out inhale and a slow, gentle exhale. Surya Namaskar A. Inhale, lift your arms up to the sky. Exhale, forward fold, let it go. Let your head hang all the way down. Inhale to a flat back, halfway lift. Elongate through your spine, little tuck to your chin. Exhale, place your hands on the earth. Carefully step back to your high plank. Come through chaturanga. So for chaturanga, we shift forward. Keep your elbows close. Come down to low plank. And then roll to the tops of the feet, knees if you need it. Upward dog. Exhale, drive your hips high. Push your hips up. Downward facing dog. Take a breath right here. Push into it a little bit deeper. And then walk back up to the top of the mat. Feet together. Inhale, flat back, halfway lift, Ardha Uttanasana. Exhale, forward fold, head drops down. Inhale, lift your arms up over your head. Hands are going to touch. And bring it into your heart as you exhale, Samnasitihi. With your breath now. Inhale, lift your arms up. Exhale, fold it forward. Let your head hang. Inhale to a flat back, halfway lift. Exhale, hands to earth. Step back, or if you want to jump back, you can. Come through your chaturanga. High plank to low plank. Inhale, earth up. Push your heart forward. Exhale, auto. Drive your hips up high. Let's do that one more time. Step or float up to the top of your mat. Feet together. Inhale, flat back, half lifting. Exhale, fold forward, let that go. Inhale, lift your arms up over your head. Hands touch. Bring it into your heart. Good. One more. Focus on the breath. Ready? Inhale, reach up. Exhale, fold through. Inhale, flatten the back. Exhale, hands to the mat. Step back. High plank to low plank. Inhale, urva. Exhale, ardha. Hips go high. Hold it here. Stay here. Three deep breaths and you're down dog. So push your hips up high. Press your chest down low. Slide your shoulders all the way down your back. Long drawn out inhales and slow exhales. Always coming back to the breath. So things in our life change, right? In our yoga practice, the constant is the breath. So we're always returning to that slow inhale and that slow exhale. On your next inhale, lift your right leg high. Lead with your heel, flex your toes, lift that leg all the way up as high as you can, keeping the hips square to the earth. As you exhale, step it through between your hands. Drop your back knee to the ground and untuck your toes. Inhale, lift your arms up. Good. Bring your hands behind your head. Interlace your grip. Inhale to a heart opener. So feel this opening up through the chest and the heart space. Fourth chakra, energetically heart chakra. This is our seat of compassion, of forgiveness, of unconditional love. So open it up, breathe it in, hold. Good. Inhale, lift your arms up high. Tuck your back toes under. And then just push yourself up. Stay right here, stay right here. Good. Make sure your hips and shoulders are square. Chest lifts. Good. Chin up. And now you've got five breaths. So you're just going to breathe in slow. You're going to breathe out slow. You are patient. You are holding. Find some space. Think about your core, pulling everything in and up. This is called Uddiyana Bandha, our abdominal lock, our center of strength and power. Sit down. You've got one more breath. Breathe in. Stay for your exhale. One more inhale. And now exhale, warrior two. So all you do for warrior two is turn that back foot out. Sit down a little lower. Arms reach wide like wings. Relax your shoulders. Good. Slight tuck to the pelvis. Gaze down your arm towards the beautiful ocean. Right, we couldn't get a better spot here. Right? So pretty. Breathe it in. And part of the yoga practice is becoming present. Right? Present through your breath and also present through like sensations. What do you feel right now? Skin, you know, breeze against your skin, the ocean, you hear the ocean. So really breathe that in. You're almost there. I haven't forgotten. Come down there. 3, 2. Now keep your legs where they are. Inhale, reverse your warrior. This is long side body stretch. We're reaching back. We're reaching back. We're breathing. Stay low in the knee. Feel it from your waistline, shooting out through your fingertips. You've got one more long inhale. Hold it right there. Now as you exhale, straighten out your front leg and then bring the arms straight to 6 and 12 o'clock. Hold here. This is called Trikonasana pose. Stay in this space. The Trikonasana pose or the triangles pose. Simple posture, so beneficial. Great for your lungs, great for your heart, great for your hips. Breathe in slow, breathe out slow. Now if you can, gaze up past your palm, because what that's going to do for you is flush out your arteries. We want that, so gaze up. Breathe in slow, breathe out slow. Now if you want, you can stay right here and just hold here and breathe for the next 5 breaths. Those of you who are maybe a little more advanced in your practice and you want to take half moon, that's an option. So gaze down. You're going to bend that knee, bring your hand out in front and kick your back leg up and off of the ground and hold there. This is our Ardha Chandrasana half moon pose. Not necessary, it's optimal. It's there if you want it. If you don't, that's okay too. 5, 3, 4. Balance. Roll that hip up. Flex your toes. 3, 2. Now landing in warrior two. So everyone's going to bend the knee and find their way back to warrior two. And we've got 5 breaths here. Now when you're in a position like this, if this is challenging for you, the tool is focusing on the breath. Every single inhale and every single exhale, you are focused. Your mind can go nowhere else if you're focused on your breath. It's a wonderful tool we can take with us off of our mat. Sit down a little lower because you're almost there. Tell yourself that your internal dialogue should be saying things like, my body is strong and light today. Posture is no problem. I've got this. One more breath. Come down one more inch. And inhale, star. Come on up to the top. Bring your toes in slightly and your heels out. Bring your arms behind you. Interlace your grip. Inhale, open up your chest and squeeze your palms flat. Exhale, prasrita C. Fold forward. Let your head hang all the way down and squeeze your palms flat. Stay right here. You have 5 breaths in this position. So in this pose, we want to think about reaching those arms up and overhead, opening through the chest and the heart space, and allowing the breath, again, to be slow and mindful so you're getting the most of this. This is a great posture, so this is a great group to tell because I know you're all moving towards being holistic and natural. This is a posture, if you get migraine headaches, that can change your world. This is a great posture for your complexion, and it's a good posture for memory, right? So I don't know if you're like me, but the memory thing happened in pregnancy and never changed, right? So this is a good one for your memory. You have one more breath right here. Exhale, drop your hands to the earth. And we're going to move into a runner's lunge towards the ocean. So that means you're going to turn your right foot out, excuse me, and then walk your hands to the inside of your right foot, and you're on the toes of your left foot, and stay right here. If you need to drop any, you can. Otherwise, just hold here. So your hand should be to the inside of your foot. So looking something like this. They should be under your shoulder. So we're just getting this deep stretch to the hips and the top of the thigh. For 5, 4. Keep breathing. 3, 2. Now engage your core. Stay strong. You're just going to step back. High plank. One breath in your high plank pose. Shift forward. Exhale, low plank. Inhale, upward dog or cobra if you need it. Roll your shoulders back. Exhale, move your hips up. Downward dog to hold and to breathe. 3 deep breaths in your downward facing dog. Push your hips up high, press your chest down low. Slide your shoulders down your back. Let's do the other side, balance it out. Inhale, left leg rises. Lead with your heel, flex your toes back in toward your body. Don't let the left hip roll open, keep it facing the earth. Lift your leg up just a little bit higher. Exhale, step it through softly between your hands. Drop your back knee to the earth, untuck your toes. Inhale, lift your arms up, reaching to the sky. Exhale, bring your hands behind your back, interlace your grip. Inhale to a heart opener. So squeeze your shoulder blades together. Again, think about here that we have going on through the chest. And inhale, your arms come high. Tuck back toes under and then push. Square your hips and your shoulders to the ocean. Slightly tuck your pelvis. Sit down lower. And then again, that idea of Uddiyana Bandha, right? Think about your core and like you have a corset on. You're pulling everything in and lifting up to make you stronger. And you're just breathing. And you're holding. Relax. Can you relax into maybe an uncomfortable situation? Breathe. Two more. Inhale. Exhale, inhale, and exhale, turn the back foot out, warrior two, sit down. So come down into your left knee, it should be right on top of your left ankle. Check your alignment here. Alignment's important because we want to be able to practice yoga for a long time, not just, 2 months. Make sure your front heel and your back arch are in line, core works hard, side tuck to the pelvis, all 5 fingers together, and you're in it. Warrior two, super strong. So this posture brings about feelings of strength, power, right? It's a warrior pose, really strong pose. So just really cultivate that in your own mind. Again, the internal dialogue. I am strong, I'm powerful, I have got this. Sit down one more inch and hold it there. Good, do not change your legs. Inhale, reverse your warrior and stay right here. You've got a couple slow breaths in that warrior pose, reverse warrior. Stay low in the knee and feel it from your waistline to your fingertips. Breathe. Good. Push your knee out a little bit more to the left. Toes out. Just there you go. 3, 2, 1. Your reverse is to Trikonasana. Just straighten out your front leg. Arms are straight. Legs are straight. Imagine that you're against a wall. That helps. So you're tucking that left hip under and you're rolling your right hip externally, rotating it on top. Gaze goes up past your palm. Your chest is open. Your heart is open. You are super strong and you're breathing in through your nose. You are breathing out through your nose. This is a posture that we call the marriage between the heart and the lungs. The lungs are almost forced to expand in this pose. We're really alivening the body. You have the option to stay right here if you did so on the other side. If you're ready for half moon, bring your hand to your hip. Bring your gaze down to the earth. Bend your left knee. Bring your hand out maybe a foot or so ahead of you and slightly to the left. As you extend your leg up toward the sky, flex the toes and hold right here. So again, that idea of rolling the hip on top, this is going to help you to maintain the pose and keep you safe. Flex your toes back. Lift your arm up high. You're there for 5. Breathe, maintain. 4. Stay calm, stay steady. 3. Hold for 2. And I release everybody as warrior 2, so find your warrior 2. Sit down. Good. Check the knee. It's on top of your ankle. Arms reach. Gaze to the ocean. Realize how blessed and lucky we are to be here, to be in our healthy bodies, to be alive. The idea of breath, so in Sanskrit the word for breath is prana. It means breath, like the actual literal breath, but it also translates to life force energy. So think about that. Think about breathing in life force. Every single cell of your body, you've got one more breath, so sit down one more inch, hold. On your next inhale, star, come on up to the top. Bring your toes in and your heels out. Bring your arms behind you. Interlace your grip, squeeze your palms flat, open up your chest. Exhale, fold forward, let it go. Head hangs down, palms are squeezing, arms are reaching. You have 5 slow breaths here. space for your body. Heart rate's coming down. Fresh oxygenated blood coming into the head, coming into the face, making you healthier, stronger, more alive. Exhale, drop your hands to the earth. Runner's lunge to the ocean. So turn that left foot all the way out. Bring it to almost the outside of your mat. Bring the hands to the inside of your mat. Keep your hips low, and you have 5 breaths here. So we're just feeling this in our body. We're gonna feel it on the top of the right thigh, deep into the left hip. Breath is slow and we're patient for 3. Holding here, stay there for 2. And then engage your core. Step back, high plank for a breath. Hold here for 1 long breath. Stay, and then hinge forward. Exhale, low plank to hold. Inhale, Urva. Push your heart forward and roll your shoulders back. Exhale, drive your hips all the way up. Downward facing dog. Long breath here. Gaze forward. Step or float to the top of your mat, feet together. Inhale to a flat back, halfway lift, Ardha Uttanasana. Exhale, crouch and curl. So lift your heels, round your back, tuck your chin, pull in really tight. Hold in that space. On your next inhale, bring your head up real slow. Walk your hands back by your hips. Bring your thighs down so they're parallel to the grass. And then pull your hands up to your heart, throne pose. Shoulders back. A lot of balance here. A lot of awareness. Focus. Don't let your mind go anywhere else but right here, right now. You have the option to stay right here. Those of you that want to take it a little bit further, lift your hips off of your heels 3 inches. And we're here for 5, 4, to touch, let your knees drop out wide. Inhale, lift your heart. Exhale, fold in. Your elbows will press against your thighs or your legs, your knees, and just pull yourself in for a double hip opener. You have 10 breaths right here. So just let your body open up. We've already made it to the ground. It's our little mini class today, right? Breathe in and breathe out slow. Come down a little deeper. Inhaling slow, exhaling slow. Feel it in your neck, feel it in your shoulders, feel it in your hips. Couple more deep breaths. Use those elbows, push your legs out. Inhale, exhale. Couple more, breathe. Fold in. Up slow. Before we get on our backs for our closing postures, I wanted to share with you a breathing exercise called alternate nostril breathing. You would most likely find this in a Kundalini style class, but I love it for moms because I feel like if you do 5 minutes of this, changes your energy completely from like a stressful day to really bring you down to again connecting to that internal peace that we all have within us. So we'll just do a little bit of that right now. Pick up your right hand and bring your 3 fingers in, like your hang loose sign here, okay? Bring your thumb to your right nostril. Inhale for your left. And then you're gonna switch, exhale. Hold the pinky there, inhale. Switch, exhale. So close your eyes, really get in the rhythm. Hold your thumb there, inhale. Switch, exhale. Hold your pinky there, inhale. Switch, exhale. To Hold your thumb there, inhale. Switch, exhale. Hold your pinky there, inhale. Switch, exhale. Hold your thumb there, inhale. Switch, exhale. Last time through, nice and slow, inhale through the left. Exhale through the right. Close your eyes, hands to heart in prayer. Three breaths. Just notice how you feel. Gently open up your eyes. Plant your feet on the ground, about hip distance apart, toes are in line with your heels, and then lower down really slow, come all the way down onto your back. When you get to your back, make sure that your fingertips can graze your heels. We're moving into bridge. If you have wheel in your practice and you'd like to take wheel, you can take it, otherwise I'll guide you through bridge. Keep your hands on the earth, fingertips on touching the heels. On an inhale, lift your hips up off of the ground and hold. Hold right there. So if you want to, you can shimmy the shoulders underneath your body and interlace your grip, squeezing your palms flat, lifting your hips up just a little higher. Now think about working through your low back and your legs, not so much your glutes. You want to strengthen the back with this pose. Breathe in. Let's take 5 breaths in this position. We inhale slow. We exhale slow. Breathe. Stay patient. So back strengthening is, you know, a preventative treatment for back issues. We want to strengthen our back to keep it strong, feeling good, and healthy. Lift up a little higher. How about one more long breath? Work, stay, and then lower down so easy and slow. Let your hands come out from underneath you, lower your bottom down. Bring your knees into your chest. Give yourself a nice big hug. Good. And now very slowly, bring your arms down to your sides, plant your palms on the earth, inhale, straight legs up toward the sky. If you have a neck injury or old injury, you might just want to stay right here. If you are feeling okay in the neck department, keep your head straight and bring your legs up and over your head, looking for the toes to touch the grass. If the toes do not touch the grass, you're just going to keep your hands at your low back, but do not move your head from left to right. The neck is in a kind of a vulnerable situation in this pose. We want to keep it in the neutral position. Legs active. Try to straighten out your legs. 5 breaths here. Inhale slow. Exhale slow. Do not move your head from left to right. Just really find your best position right here. Good. Breathing. Inhale slow. Exhale slow. This is an amazing, amazing posture for relieving tension and stress that we all hold here in our shoulders and our neck. This is a stress relieving pose. Now, as you're ready, bring your hands to your low back. Extend your legs up to the sky and hold right there. Shoulder stand. The feet should be over the hips, not the face. What this is doing is letting that blood come back down to the heart, so it gives your heart a little bit of a break. Breathe. Inhale slow. Exhale slow. 3 more breaths. Finding your best position in your shoulder stand. Lift up a little bit higher. Keep reaching those feet up toward the sky. Hold it there. Good. Now as you exhale, slowly bend your knees, bringing your knees towards your ears. For deaf man's pose, ear pinch pose. Just 2 breaths here. Inhaling slow, exhaling slow. Stay patient. 1 more inhale. As you exhale, lower down easy. Come all the way down to the ground and pull both knees into your chest. and give yourself one more big hug. Squeeze in nice and tight. Feet are together, not crossing. They're side by side. Pull the knees in. Keep your head on the ground. This is a compression on your transverse colon, aiding digestion, elimination. Hold there. Now keep your right knee in. Extend your left leg down onto the earth. Interlace the grip. All 10 fingers interlace 2 inches below your right knee. Good. Squeeze in a little bit tighter. And then your left hand is going to guide your right knee across your body. As your right arm goes out wide to a T, allowing the twist to happen through the midsection. This is a great pose for detox. So detox is a big buzzword right now, right? Everyone's detox everything. This is helping you from the inside out, cleansing the internal organs, promoting good digestion. So just hold here for one more breath. This is also a really calming posture. You can take this before you go to bed at night. It'll help you have a more restful night's sleep. Slowly come back to the center, right leg down, pull the left knee in. Interlace your grip, squeeze in nice and tight, pull that knee up toward your armpit, push your shoulders down and onto the earth. Feel that nice little pinch here in your left side. This is compressing your descending colon. Your right hand now is gonna pull the left knee across the body as the left arm goes out wide to a T, and that deep, nice twist happens to cleanse the body and calm the mind. We've got a few slow breaths right here, so find your best way into your nice deep twist. Hold and breathe, hold and breathe, hold and breathe right there. And then come back to the center. Both knees come in for one last big hug. Draw your knees in, show yourself some love. Pull your knees in tight. Thank yourself for your hard work today. And then as you're ready, release to your final Shavasana. Arms at your sides, palms face up, close your eyes. And we'll just guide you through maybe a minute or two here of a relaxation pose, Shavasana pose. Watch your next inhale, lungs expand. As you exhale, relax your chest, shoulders, relax your neck, face, and jaw. Any tension around the eyes or the mouth, you don't need it, so let it go. Watch the next slow breath come in. As you exhale, relax your back. Take it down your arms, your elbows, your forearms, your wrists, all the way out through your fingertips. Watch the next slow breath come in, lungs expand out. As you exhale, relax your hips, glutes, quadriceps, knees, calf muscles, shins, tops of feet, ankles, and toes. Let your toes go. Watch your next slow inhale breath come in, lungs expand, chest rises. As you exhale, allow your whole body to melt that much heavier to the earth below you. And take a moment right now just to soak it in. Just 30 seconds to a minute here. Just really be present, how you feel, how relaxed you feel. That idea of, you know, just kind of coming back to our own inner peace, realizing it's there at all times. And we have many different ways to get back. Our yoga practice is just one of those ways. Take a few more slow breaths. Again, your quote this morning, by one of my favorites, Elizabeth Gilbert, she said, "We don't realize that somewhere within us all, there does exist a supreme self who is eternally at peace." So maybe set that intention to move through the rest of your day with that little bit of peace, a little bit of love, a little bit of light, and keep it with you. Inhale, slowly start to wiggle your fingers and your toes, inviting a little bit of life back into your body, waking the body up. Inhale, reach your arms up long over your head, reach back, push your belly up, arch your back, reach, reach, reach. You're waking up for the first time, deciding what an amazing, amazing day you're going to have today. Exhale, roll over onto your right side, taking fetal position for 2 breaths. Take a moment just to thank yourself for your time, for coming out to something like this, and for honoring yourself and maybe giving yoga practice a shot. As you are ready, come up to a seat and we'll close. We'll cross our legs and sit up nice and tall. Bringing the hands to the heart center, same way we started class is the way we'll finish. Close your eyes, slight tuck to the chin, bowing inward. Take a moment just to really, again, become aware of that beautiful internal peace that we can come back to day after day, year after year. On an inhale, we raise our thumbs up to third eye center, the seat just above and between your eyebrows. As we exhale, we bow forward, sealing in our practice with a deep breath of gratitude. For this practice we call yoga, for the community of yogis, for this beautiful community and for this space. It is always my honor, my pleasure to guide the practice. Thank you for joining me. Have a beautiful day today. Om Shanti Shanti. Namaste. Thank you guys so much.